EPT circuit is broken down into two different systems. There's Korea and there's everybody else. Let's talk about Korea first. Korea is mostly about a tournament circuit called GSL, which has been around since the beginning of StarCraft II. It's a $120,000 prize pool tournament that operates in three different stages. First of all, you have the qualifiers that take place over 2 days. We have 16 players that manage to make it into Code A and 4 players that manage to make it into Code S. Code A is a single round best of 5 where 16 players play 8 matches and the winner moves on, the loser gets $2,000. In Code S, you take the 16 players that made it there, stick them into 4 groups of 4, make them play out top 2 advance, and then you play the rest of it out into a single elimination bracket. The winner of the tournament is crowned the best player in Korea, gets a seat to IEM Katowice, the big global finals that happens at the end of the year, and of course there's $20,000 for first place and $4,000 just for making it into Code S. 3 seasons of GSL take place every year, and there's also an accompanying tournament called GSL Super Tournament that is very simple, has some qualifiers and then a bunch of players play in a single elimination bracket. Now the non-Korean circuit is broken down into 6 different regional competitions that are based on the strength of each one of those regions: Europe, North America, Latin America, China, Taiwan, and Oceania. All the regions follow relatively the same format where you have a group stage that then moves into a double elimination bracket. Europe and North America both have too many players, so they divide the players into groups of 8 and make them play in a big round robin to see which 4 players are going to advance out from each one of these 4 groups and then make them play in the double elimination bracket. The other regions only have 8 players that manage to qualify for each one of these tournaments, so they have 4 players that are put into 2 groups and play out a GSL style group that then goes into a double elimination bracket where the top 2 advance out from each one of those groups. Prize pools for each one of the regions is also based on the strength of the regions themselves, where Europe has a $74,000 prize pool, North America has a $33,600 prize pool, Latin America and China both have a $14,500 prize pool, and the bottom 2 regions, Taiwan and Oceania, have a $12,200 prize pool. After all the regional competitions have played out, the top players from each one of the respective regions move on to a season finals, which is a $50,000 event, where a certain number of players, depending on the strength of the region, advance onto the season finals. We have 4 spots for Europe, 2 spots for North America, and 1 spot for all the other regions except for Korea, which also gets actually 6 spots, top 4 players from that season of GSL, and 2 play-in spots for the players that were knocked out in the round 8 of that season of GSL. The season finals itself plays out identical to GSL Code S, where there are 16 players, 4 groups of 4, top 2 advance, then a single elimination bracket with the remaining 8 players with a $10,000 first place prize and a $1,250,000 last place prize. Now during all this, there's also a weekly event called the EPT Weekly, or also known as the Big Gabe Weekly, where a $400 single elimination tournament is run every single Monday or Sunday for North America, Europe, and Korea, each one respectively, totaling to $1,200 per week. Oh, and by the way, every single one of the events that we've been talking about so far are also awarding something called EPT points. What are EPT points? EPT points are a system that we use for 2 things, seeding as well as qualifications. The main purpose of EPT points is to qualify yourself for IEM Katowice, which is an annual tournament that crowns the global champion for the year, even though it takes place after all the seasons have finished up in February the following year. The tournament has a $500,000 prize pool and has 36 players that manage to qualify throughout the year through using a combination of EPT points as well as the winners of regional events. Qualified players for the round of 24 are 3 GSL winners, 3 of the DreamHack season final winners, the top 5 EPT point holders in Korea, the top 8 EPT point holders for the various EPT circuit regions, including 4 from Europe, 2 from North America, 1 from China, and 1 from Latin America, as well as the top point holder across all of the circuit systems if you merge all the point systems together and that player has not been invited yet. Those 20 players are seeded directly into the second stage of the tournament, whereas the next 16 players in each region's point standings go to the first stage, which is also known as the play-in stage, with 7 from Korea, 3 from Europe, 2 from Taiwan, 1 from North America, 1 from Latin America, 1 from China, and 1 from Oceania qualifying to the play-in stage. The play-in stage is those 16 players playing in a double elimination bracket, with the top 4 advancing out into the round-robin stage. The round-robin stage is 24 players who are divided into 4 groups of 6, and each one of them play each other with the top 3 advancing. After that, the top 12 players begin a single elimination bracket, with the top 4 players from each one of their respective groups being seeded in a single round until a champion is crowned and they win $170,000 for first place. The conclusion of IEM Katowice marks the end of the year for StarCraft and is supposed to crown a global champion that we celebrate as the best player of that year. But throughout the year, there's a lot of other StarCraft 2 events that are happening that are totally unrelated to the circuit, such as the Team Liquid Star League, which boasts a $30,000 prize pool and also awards EPT points, but then there's also other events such as GSL Super Tournament, which awards a $25,000 prize pool and doesn't actually offer EPT points. There's also a constant stream of community events such as Cheesadelphia, Stay at Home Story Cup, Wardy TV, Lima League, and so on and so forth. If you ever want to find out more information about any events that are happening right now or coming up, you can head over to TL.net and you can look at that right-hand sidebar that has a calendar of all the events that are happening or coming up. You can also head over to reddit.com/r/StarCraft if you want to post a bunch of memes about StarCraft related things, and you can head over to twitch.tv/StarCraft and go to the StarCraft 2 category if you want to find most of these events that are happening. And if you found any of this confusing or spotted any errors, head over to twitter.com/Rotterdam08 and tweet at him any of your questions or concerns. Thanks for watching.